Hi, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is a Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Do you know what scientists call animals that eat meat?
Carnivore!
That's right. Tyrannosaurs like Buddy and Annie were carnivores, so they had to hunt for their food. Can you think of any animals that you've seen, maybe at the zoo, that are carnivores? Absolutely. Lions have a lot of the same features as T-Rex. Of course, both have big, sharp teeth that are great for eating meat. And the teeth also help them hunt other animals. Paleontologists can tell from looking at T-Rex skulls that this dinosaur had excellent eyesight. That's something else they share with lions. Another cool trait that helped T-Rex find food was a great sense of smell. Lots of living animals like lions and wolves have a much better sense of smell than we do, so they can sniff animals from a long way away. Dinosaurs like T-Rex may have done the very same thing, using keen eyesight and a super sense of smell to hunt for their food. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries. Scott the paleontologist, and this is a brachiosaurus. Can you think of an animal alive today that has a long neck and reaches way up high into trees to eat leaves?
Giraffes.
And they're herbivores, which means they only eat plants. That's just like the brachiosaurus. They love plants too. And both the brachiosaurus and the giraffe are really tall. And they both have super long necks, so they can eat leaves from the bottom and the middle and the tops of trees. Brachiosaurus was so tall that they could reach leaves over 40 feet off the ground. That's like four school buses stacked on top of each other. Now that's tall. So remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Dr. Scott, the paleontologist. Hey guys, I'm down here. This dinosaur is so big you can barely see me. Do you know what kind of dinosaur this is?
Argentinosaurus.
That's right. This is an Argentinosaurus, one of the largest animals ever to live on land. Now, what's the biggest animal living on land today? Argentinosaurus was about 100 feet long. That's as long as five elephants put together. An Argentinosaurus weighed about as much as 20 elephants. Now that's a lot of dinosaur. And just like elephants do today, Argentinosaurus must have eaten an amazing amount of plant food. Paleontologists still wonder how Argentinosaurus could have eaten enough food with such a small head. Now how do elephants reach high up into trees to find food?
With their trunks.
Argentinosaurus didn't have a trunk, but it did have a long neck that it probably used to reach high into trees. And being such a gigantic animal, it probably spent most of the day just trying to find enough of the green stuff to keep itself going. Okay, remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Hi, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist. Can you think of any animals you've seen sniffing around on the ground?
A dog.
Right. Dogs use their great sense of smell to find things like
food.
Yeah. And we think that tyrannosaurs also had a great sense of smell, which they used to track other animals when they were hunting. Tracking means that animals follow smells like detectives until they find where the scent is coming from. Plenty of other animals have a great sense of smell. For example, bears and wolves, some fishes, even moths. In fact, most animals have a better sense of smell than humans do. We depend mostly on our eyesight, but for many other animals, a great sense of smell is just as important as being able to see. T-Rex was probably more like a bear or a dog, relying on a great sense of smell to find its food. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Ornithomimus. The most important thing to know about Ornithomimus is that it was really fast. Where'd it go?
There it is.
In fact, scientists think that Ornithomimus may have been one of the fastest dinosaurs ever. How could they run so fast? Well, for one thing, Ornithomimus was bipedal, which means that it moved around on its two back legs, and those back legs were very long. Great for running fast. Can you think of any bipedal animals alive today? Kangaroos and humans, that is, people like you and me, both move around on their back legs. But there is one bipedal animal, a big bird, that looks a whole lot like Ornithomimus.
Ostrich!
Exactly. The ostrich and Ornithomimus have plenty in common. Both have a small head, a long neck, and strong legs. And they both ran really fast. Ostriches can easily escape any predators trying to catch them. And Ornithomimus was probably the same, outrunning meat-eaters like T-Rex. Wow, don't think I could run that fast. But I'll try. Keep watching for Dinosaur Discovery! Dinosaur Train! Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist. Can you name what kind of creature Buddy is?
T-Rex!
Their teeth to slice and tear up meat. And Tyrannosaurus had a lot of teeth, about 60 of them. Most kids, like you, have only 20 teeth. Tyrannosaurus had some of the largest teeth of any meat-eating dinosaur. And believe it or not, its teeth kept falling out. But those lost teeth were always replaced by new teeth. Can you think of an animal alive today that constantly loses and replaces its teeth? Sharks are always growing new teeth, just like T-Rex and most other dinosaurs did. So don't forget, since you only get two sets of teeth, you better take good care of them. Okay, remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Microraptor. A lot of people think that all dinosaurs were big, but some were very small. Microraptor was one of the smallest dinosaurs of all. It was only about 2 feet long, around the size of a small dog.
Look!
Now, can you see what it's covered with?
It looks like feathers.
Yup, Microraptor was a feathered dinosaur with wings. And not just two wings, but one wing on each front leg and one wing on each back leg. Four wings altogether. Something really strange? With all those wings, you'd think that Microraptor would be great at flying. But actually, it didn't fly at all. We do think that it did glide, though. Microraptor may have climbed trees, leaped into the air, and then used its feathered wings to glide downward, maybe even catching other animals in the air. Today, flying squirrels do the very same thing. They don't fly because they don't have wings. Instead, flying squirrels glide, just the way we think that Microraptor did. Pretty amazing, huh? Okay, that's it for now. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries. Migrating animals to stay close to their food. just the way we think the T-Rex might have.
Hungry!
All this talk about food is making me hungry, so I'm gonna migrate out of here and find something to eat. But remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Ineosaurus. Called amphibians, which live in
Liberty Mutual customized my car insurance, and I saved hundreds. With all the money I saved, thought I'd buy stilts.
Hi, honey.
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Uoplacephalus.
Uoplacephalus.
Now, what dinosaur do you think of when you look at Uoplacephalus? Kylosaurus and Uoplacephalus both belong to the same family of dinosaurs called Ankylosaurs, which includes many other armored dinosaurs. Uoplacephalus looks like a smaller version of Ankylosaurus. Both of these plant eaters had armor covering their heads and bodies, and both had bony clubs at the end of their tails. Can you think of some animals living today that have armor covering their bodies? Examples. Another amazing armored animal alive today is the pangolin. Its armor is made of plate-like scales that cover the entire body, making this African animal look like a giant pine cone. Whoa, great armor. If threatened, a pangolin will curl up into a ball with all that armor providing great protection. Pretty amazing, huh? Okay, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. The good mother, because in addition to the fossils of grown-up animals, they found remains of nests, eggs, and babies. It looks like the moms, and maybe the dads too, brought plant food to the babies who stayed in the family nest for a while after hatching. Today, lots of animal moms take care of their babies after they're born, including elephants, whales, and even crocodiles. And what kind of animal is this?
A kangaroo.
Stay particularly close to their kids. Birds are also very good animal moms. Here's a bird you may know.
It's a robin.
Robins guard their babies, find all their food, and teach them to fly. Robins are really good moms. Now, there's plenty of great moms in the world of animals today, and it's amazing to think that dinosaur moms were taking care of their babies more than 65 million years ago. Here's to all you moms out there. Great job. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discovery. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is a Amargosaurus. Amargosaurus was a giant, long-necked dinosaur, or sauropod, like Brachiosaurus. Amargosaurus was discovered in South America, and it had one big feature that made it stand out from all the rest of the sauropods.
Big spines on its back.
Right. Paleontologists like me aren't sure what those tall spines were used for. One idea is that the spines made Amargosaurus look bigger, so that it can show off to others of its kind. Now, can you think of any animal alive today that shows off and tries to make itself look bigger?
A peacock.
That's a great example. Another idea is that the tall spines helped Amargosaurus cool off when it was getting too hot. And today, there's a giant animal in Africa that kind of does the same thing, flapping its big ears to cool off. Dinosaur discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Confucius Ornis. Confucius Ornis was discovered in China. It's named after Confucius, a famous and wise Chinese teacher.
Confucius Ornis!
Confucius Ornis is a bird that lived during the time of the dinosaurs. It was about the size of a crow, but with very long
tail feathers. Paleontologists working in Asia have found hundreds of fossil skeletons of this animal, making it one of the best-known ancient birds. Now, how do we know about the feathers of Confucius ornis? That's right. The fossils actually have feather impressions, and some of the impressions show a long pair of tail feathers. Can you think of another bird with long tail feathers?
A peacock.
Right. One skeleton of Confucius ornis was actually found with a few fish bones inside, so they probably ate fish at least some of the time. But they may also have eaten fruits, seeds, and bugs. Today, there's a beautiful bird called the quetzal that eats seeds, fruits, insects, as well as other foods. And it even has a long tail like Confucius ornis. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Iguanodon.
Iguanodon.
Dinosaurs ever found. Its bones were discovered in England in 1822. When iguanodon fossils were dug up, people didn't even know what dinosaurs looked like. Imagine being one of the first people ever to see huge dinosaur bones. The name of this dinosaur means iguana tooth because the teeth of iguanodon look kind of like the teeth of lizards known as iguanas. At first, scientists thought that dinosaurs must have looked like giant lizards. So that's how they made iguanodon look, like a giant lizard. Today, we know that iguanodon didn't look much like a lizard at all. Instead of being sprawled, iguanodon walked on four legs when moving slowly and switched to two legs when going faster. Paleontologists also found a strange pointed bone with the fossils of iguanodon. At first, they thought it was a horn that went on the nose, but it turned out to be a big spike on the end of the thumb. Today, we paleontologists are still learning lots of brand new things about very old dinosaurs. So, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Kentrosaurus. Kentrosaurus was a big four-legged herbivore, or plant eater, that lived in the Jurassic time period. Now, can you think of another dinosaur that looks similar to Kentrosaurus?
Stegosaurus.
That's right. Kentrosaurus and Stegosaurus have a lot in common. Both have plates and spikes along their backbones, both ate plants, and both belong to the same family of dinosaurs that we call Stegosaurus. But these two dinosaurs have some big differences, too. For example, Kentrosaurus lived in Africa, and Stegosaurus lived far away in North America. Kentrosaurus has lots of plates and spikes along its back, whereas Stegosaurus had some huge plates along its back. Paleontologists aren't sure how Stegosaurus used those bony plates. One idea is that they helped cool them off on hot days. But both of these animals had amazing spiky tails that were probably used to fight off big carnivores like Allosaurus. Pretty amazing, huh? Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is a Corythosaurus. All Corythosaurus, like Cory, were part of a group of dinosaurs called hadrosaurs, or duckbills, because they had wide beaks, just like ducks. Do you think Corythosaurus used its crest to make sounds? Well, scientists like me think they may have, because the crest was hollow. Air went inside it when they breathed. So, if the dinosaur took a deep breath and blew the air through its nose, it could have made a loud sound that sounded kind of like a horn.
Point of fact. Actually, dinosaurs did not perform musical concerts. Thank you.
But, like I said, they probably did make cool noises with their crests.
Yay!
So
Why would Carithosaurus use their amazing crest to make noises?
It's a lot like the birds you hear singing and chirping in your backyard. Carithosaurus may have made sounds to say things like,
"Hey, check out this crest!
Stay out of my way!"
Dinosaurs probably did a whole lot of things that animals do today. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist. What do you call animals that eat only plants?
Herbivores.
And can you think of a few herbivores walking around today?
Cows,
giraffes, and rabbits are all herbivores or plant eaters. And our friend Triceratops was a herbivore too. This big guy ate nothing but the green stuff. Triceratops had a lot of great features that came in handy for eating plants. It had a huge beak up front and hundreds of teeth in the back of the mouth. Triceratops is often compared with a big animal living today.
Rhinoceros.
Both Triceratops and rhinoceros are big plant eaters with big appetites and
big horns. Herbivores.
Yeah, herbivores. So remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries.
Hi, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Cryolophosaurus.
Dinosaurs.
Cryolophosaurus.
Probably the first thing you notice about Cryolophosaurus is its crest. In fact, the name means cold crest lizard because scientists discovered this dinosaur way down south on the continent of Antarctica. It's really cold there now.
Did it live in the snow?
Nope. When dinosaurs were alive, Antarctica was much, much warmer than it is today. So what do you think about that bony crest on its head?
It's big.
Swoops up. The scientists who first discovered this animal thought that its strange crest looked like the hair of Elvis Presley, a famous rock and roll singer.
A fact. Cryolophosaurus did not know Elvis and did not sing rock songs.
Aww.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, that's true. But scientists nicknamed Cryolophosaurus the Elvisaurus. Nickname make it a very cool dinosaur. All right, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Dinosaur.
Hi, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and these are T-Rex footprints. Paleontologists have discovered thousands of dinosaur footprint fossils. They've been found on every continent.
Dinosaur footprints.
Sometimes we just find one footprint, and sometimes we find a long series of footprints called trackways. Fossil trackways tell us how dinosaurs moved. Tracks tell us that dinosaurs stood upright with their feet close together. And since we don't find many signs of dragging tails, we know that dinosaurs held their tails in the air.
That's cool.
Paleontologists have also found trackways of sprawling crocodiles and slithering snakes and hopping frogs. Of course, animals living today make tracks too. You've probably seen some right around your own home. Hey, I've got an idea. Get outside, get into nature, and make your own footprint discoveries.
I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Cartoxy Rhino.
Cartoxy Rhino. Cartoxy Rhino. Cartoxy Rhino.
Right, the age of dinosaurs included lots of giant animals that aren't around anymore. But Cryolophosaurus is different. It still has some very close relatives swimming in the oceans today.
Sharks.
Yep, Cryolophosaurus was a giant shark, one of the biggest predators in the Mesozoic seas. And it looks a lot like today's great white shark. Now, isn't nature amazing? Here we have two sharks, one ancient and the other living today, that look almost the same. These animals tell us that sharks have been successful underwater predators for a long, long time. Now, what are some of the things that may have made sharks so good at surviving?
Sharp teeth. A great nose.
Yeah, sharks have razor-sharp teeth. sense of smell. They also have sleek bodies and big fins that are great for swimming fast. All of these features help make sharks terrific hunters. Okay, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Can you think of some animals? Dinosaurs.
Parasaurolophus has
had one outstanding feature that's hard to miss.
Its crest.
Yeah, the head crest on Parasaurolophus is amazing. Paleontologists aren't sure, but we think that the crest may have been used to make the animal look bigger and to make sounds. Much like bird calls, Parasaurolophus probably made sounds to communicate with others of its kind. The hooting could have been used to defend territory.
This is my territory!
Or tell other animals of approaching predators.
There's a tyrannosaur over there!
Or simply let other Parasaurolophus know where to find them.
Yo, I'm way over here.
Other dinosaurs besides Parasaurolophus had bony crests on their heads, like Lambiosaurus. And some animals alive today have head crests that you definitely can't miss. For example, the crested chameleon. It doesn't make sounds with its head crest, but it certainly attracts attention.
Hello, hello, hello.
Good looking guy, huh? Okay, remember, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Spinosaurus.
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 Now, what's the first thing you notice about Spinosaurus?
It had a big ridge on its back.
Yup, paleontologists call that ridge a sail, and it grew up to 6 feet tall. That's as big as some of your parents. Now, can you guess what a Spinosaurus sail was for?
Scare off other dinosaurs.
To keep the dinosaur cool.
You guys are smart. Those are some of the same ideas that paleontologists have suggested. Now, do you notice anything else kind of strange about this dinosaur?
It has a really long head.
Exactly. Some scientists think that this giant meat eater used its long snout to catch fish. Can you think of an animal alive today with a long snout that also likes to catch fish?
Crocodiles.
That's right. We think that Spinosaurus may have caught fish like crocodiles do today.
Crocodiles stay very still, and when a fish swims by, they lunge quickly with their long snouts and grab it.
Okay, remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is a Stegosaurus.
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 Stegosaurus, like Morris, had plates on their back, but we don't know exactly what they used them for. One idea, or hypothesis, is that Stegosaurus used their plates to make themselves look even bigger, maybe to scare away meat eaters or to show off to other dinosaurs. Another hypothesis is that they use their plates to cool themselves off. Since we can't watch Stegosaurus in action, paleontologists like to look at animals today to see what we can learn for them. And there is one animal we all know that is a big plant eater with a long trunk and big ears that it uses for cooling off and showing off.
Elephant.
Big elephants use their ears to make themselves look bigger so they can scare off other elephants or even meat eaters like lions. And elephants also use their ears to cool themselves off. They push warm blood from inside their bodies out into their ears and then flap their ears back and forth like huge fans. This cools the blood, which then goes back into the body, keeping the whole animal cooler. Let's hear it for the Stegosaurus.
Yay!
Watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Despletosaurus.
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 Despletosaurus, like Tyrannosaurus rex, was part of a family of dinosaurs known as tyrannosaurs. Despletosaurus shared a lot of things in common with its famous cousin, T-Rex. Both were bipedal, which means that they walked on two legs. Both had tiny arms with only two fingers on each hand. And both had large heads with mouths full of large, sharp teeth, perfect for eating meat.
Point of fact. Tyrannosaurus and and the Stegosaurus did not live at the same time. Thank you.
Well, that's a very good point. A fact. Both of these big carnivores lived during the Cretaceous period, but Dinosaurus lived millions of years before T-Rex. And there's another pretty big difference between these two Tyrannosaurs. Dinosaurus was actually smaller than T-Rex. A grown-up Dinosaurus was about 30 feet long, almost as long as a school bus. But Tyrannosaurus was much bigger, over 40 feet long, making it one of the biggest meat-eaters ever to walk on land. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Acorns on its head. Acorn roots.
horns were used for. Since Digimolik isn't around anymore, we can't see them in action. But there are a lot of animals alive today that have horns, like goats. A lot of them lock horns together with another animal of the same kind. And then they have pushing and shoving matches to see who's the strongest. Other times, horns are used to show off, to make the animal look bigger. But the short, sharp horns of Stichomolek are most like the horns of mountain goats. These goats use their horns to butt into the side of other mountain goats. And it's possible the Stichomolek used their horns to do the same thing. What do you think? I wonder what it'd be like to have horns. Nice horns, too. Okay, that's it for now. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries. Dinosaur? Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist. Can you name what kind of creature Tiny, Shiny, and Dawn are?
Pteranodon.
Yes, they're all pteranodons.
Point of fact. Actually, pteranodons were not dinosaurs. Thank you.
Pteranodons did fly around with birds above the heads of dinosaurs. And guess what we think pteranodon liked to eat the most?
Fish!
Pteranodon loved fish. Can you think of any flying animals today that are fish eaters?
Pelicans!
The pelican that catches fish almost the same way we think our pteranodon pals did. Diving into the water from above and scooping up fish with their long beaks.
Nice dive.
So, remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Hi, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist. We used to think that dinosaurs were covered with scales. You may be surprised to learn that some dinosaurs, like Velociraptor, actually had feathers, even though they couldn't fly. Can you think of any birds alive today that have feathers but can't fly?
An ostrich.
Ostriches have wings and feathers but can't fly. Any others?
Penguins.
That's right. Penguins also have feathers but can't fly. They use their wings to swim and catch food underwater. Peacocks have beautiful colored feathers that they use mostly for showing off instead of for flying. And it's possible that Velociraptor and other dinosaurs also had colorful feathers that they used for show.
Point of fact, dinosaurs did not put on fashion shows. Thank you.
Well, that's true, but a lot of dinosaurs, like Velociraptor, did have cool-looking feathers. Birds also use their feathers to stay warm. And it's possible that Velociraptor did the same. Having a covering of feathers is a lot like having a warm coat to wear when it's cold outside. Looks like you kids could use some Velociraptor feathers. Well, that's all for now. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Dinosaur train!
Hi, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist. Hey, that's a nice frill you've got there. Paleontologists used to think that Triceratops and other horned dinosaurs used their frills for fighting off big meat-eaters like Tyrannosaurus rex. But now we think that these big bony frills were probably used to show off to other Triceratops. The frill makes this dinosaur look much bigger. There's a very cool lizard alive today called the frill neck lizard. Whenever it needs to scare off other animals, it raises its frill to make itself look bigger. Triceratops wasn't able to raise and lower its frill. Instead, the frill was always up, and the head of Triceratops was huge, about 10 feet long, the biggest head of any land-living animal ever. So remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Elasmosaurus.
Elasmosaurus
was a giant marine reptile from the Cretaceous time period. The word
word marine means that it lived in the ocean. Now, what do you notice first about Elasmosaurus?
It has a really long neck.
Absolutely. The neck of Elasmosaurus was over 20 feet long. That's more than half the length of its body. Can you think of a dinosaur that has a long neck?
Brachiosaurus.
That's right. Brachiosaurus and Elasmosaurus both had long necks, even though one lived in the water and one lived on the land. Scientists think that the long neck of Elasmosaurus helped it hunt for fish.
Let's go fishing!
Wow, you guys are great swimmers. Because of its large size, Elasmosaurus was probably a slow swimmer. So it may have swum under large schools of fish and then used its long neck to reach up and grab its prey with those long, sharp teeth.
Whoa!
Okay. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Their homes.
away from predators, it's also a good place to be if it's really hot or really cold above ground. That's all for now. Remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Deinonychus.
Deinonychus.
And what's the first thing you notice when you look at this meat-eating dinosaur? Exactly. Every Deinonychus has a very big, very sharp claw on each foot. So big and sharp that we call them terrible claws. Do you know what they did with their claws?
Point of fact, dinosaurs did not put on art shows. Thank you.
But Deinonychus probably did use their terrible claws to catch other animals. For sure, some paleontologists think that Deinonychus lived and hunted in groups or packs like lions and wolves do today. Living in a group might have allowed a few Deinonychus to work together to find food and maybe even attack dinosaurs that were much bigger than they were.
That's scary.
You can imagine that a group of Deinonychus coming at you with all of their killing claws and big sharp teeth would have been pretty scary.
Really scary.
Scientists think so, too. I gotta go. Remember, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries. Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is the feathered dinosaur known as Troodon.
Troodon.
Did you know that scientists think that Troodons were some of the smartest dinosaurs?
Point of fact, Troodons did not drive trains.
Why do you think Troodons were so smart? Well, because they had some of the largest brains of any dinosaur. Being smart, Troodons could probably stay away from predators that wanted to eat them. And what do you think Troodons like to eat?
They like plants. They like meat.
You're both right. Paleontologists think that Troodon may have eaten plants and meat. An animal that eats both meat and plants is called an omnivore. Can you think of any omnivores that are alive today?
Bear.
Great answer. Bears, pigs, crows, even humans are omnivores.
Me too.
Yes, we humans, at least most of us, are omnivores too. We eat meat, like fish and chicken and beef, and plants, like rice, fruits, and vegetables. So we have a few things in common with those little troodons. We're both smart, and we're both omnivores. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and these are both troodons.
But they look different.
Great observation, they are different. Troodons live way up north in the Arctic, and also way down south. We don't know for sure, but it's possible that troodons living in the far north had more feathers to help keep them warm.
Like wearing a coat.
Just like humans wear coats to stay warm, some birds use a thicker covering of feathers. And dinosaurs like Troodon may have done the same thing.
Point of fact, troodons did not play games like ice hockey.
True, but troodons living way up north probably did see some ice and snow during the winter.
Yay!
Can you think of any animals alive today with feathers or fur that live in cold climates?
Bears.
That's true. Some bears grow extra fur on their bodies to help them stay warm during really cold winter months. And during winter, there's lots of
snow.
Back in the age of dinosaurs, though, it was a lot warmer than it is today, so the North Pole wasn't covered in snow and ice all the time. Well, that's all for now. Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Therizinosaurus. Therizinosaurus was an amazing plant-eating dinosaur from the Cretaceous time period. It had three super long curved claws on each hand that may have been used to fight off predators or to pull down tree branches when eating. But with its small head, long neck,
Dinosaurs did have really cool claws. This strange beast was giant. It grew up to 30 feet long and weighed as much as a small elephant. And Therizinosaurus' arms were huge too, up to 8 feet long. Paleontologists often compare Therizinosaurus to the living tree sloth, which also has very long claws. Sloths tend to move very slowly, and that's how we think Therizinosaurus moved as well. Okay, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Patinosaurus. The Patinosaurus was about this big.
It looks small.
Yeah, Patinosaurus was a small animal, although it did have pretty big wings. Believe it or not, even though Patinosaurus was a reptile that lived with dinosaurs, it wasn't a dinosaur itself.
It wasn't a dinosaur!
Nope. Patinosaurus and all of its flying reptile cousins, including pteranodons, are called pterosaurs. It's not a dinosaur, it's a pterosaur.
It's a pterosaur.
Patinosaurus was very similar to most bats. Both are small, both can fly, and many bats are insect eaters, using their speed to catch bugs in the air. So remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries. Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist. This is Pliosaurus. Pliosaurus was a giant reptile up to 40 feet long, which made it one of the biggest and most feared ocean predators during the Jurassic time period. It hunted all kinds of animals, even other predators like sharks and plesiosaurs. That's why some people call Pliosaurus the T-Rex of the ocean. Pliosaurus had a long, low head with powerful jaws full of sharp teeth. It also had a short neck and a long, thin body that helped it swim really fast. Paleontologists don't know for sure, but Pliosaurus may have swum like modern sea lions, using their four large flippers to paddle through the water. No matter how they moved around, Pliosaurus could probably swim fast enough to chase down their prey. Can you think of other modern-day predators that can swim fast enough to catch their prey underwater?
Sharks. Seals.
Those are great examples. Sharks and seals both swim fast enough to catch their prey underwater. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.